job this morning is to spoon all the water out of that pit. Probably shouldn't have left the pit there, but never mind. We did. So now we're going to empty it all out so that we have no water. To avoid too much abuse. probably have been fired 17 times over by now. much more of this because we've only got so much battery. All of that there is all going to be dug out. So if I'd like to get a lot of that recorded, so I will probably stop recording this in a minute, spend a few hours playing around in the mud, and then we'll see about, I've got a written fence line out, and start removing all of those trees in there, which I thought would be a bit more interesting. We've only got about 2.5 hours of battery life on the camera, and it's a camera that is the budget version, so it doesn't have spare batteries. You can't take the battery out, you've got to charge it. You might be able to get a bit more life in it later on, and find a way to plug it in. But there's no guarantee. Well, you can see that a load of water that's running back in from where we've spooned it all out. So I dug out a load of stone, so we're going to take some of this soft rubbish over here. This is all the peaty boggy muck that was sitting on the top. It's about 2 feet right the way across this field. So we're going to start taking this, and I'm going to put this into the bottom of the hole, and then we put stone back over the top. It's to make a hard pad for the animals during the winter. So it's not going to be taking vehicle traffic. So once this has been spread out over the top, and you've then got about 4 feet of hardcore over the top, it'll be absolutely fine for the animals during the winter. It might seem a little bit odd, putting all of this soft rubbish in the bottom and then putting your hardcore on top of that, but as it's only animals that are going to be using it, it's not going to get muddy very quickly. It'll stay nut, and it's also, we're going to raise the level slightly so that it's going to be sticking up above the surrounding area, and other than when the river floods and comes right the way through, it's not a strong current when the river floods, it just sits it all in water, and then that'll all drain away again. And this will give the animals somewhere dry down here for a much longer period of the year when they're not completely shut up in the sheds. We don't want them shut in the sheds all the time. We want to have it so that they are able to come down here, but at the moment in the winter this is just they sink up to their bellies. So we don't want them doing that. What we're gonna do now, see those trees in front of the bucket? We're going to take this hardcore patch all the way back there, and we're going to do the same thing. It's going to be the same process all the way through. Dig a big hole, bury as much of the muck down in the big hole, scrape all the muck off, and then we've got a nice hard surface, and then we're going to be digging up some other hardcore from elsewhere, bring it over here, and then take the whole level up even higher. Nice and easy. What I'm going to do now is going to put in a load of this muck, bring it up a little way, and spread some of that stone over the top of it. Then I'm going to stop and I'm going to have a cup of coffee while we let some of the water sort of percolate down into this material, hopefully dissipate a little bit. What we don't want to do is to fill it right up and then have all that water rush straight into the river, because that will pollute the water and people get upset when you do that. We don't want to do that. Also, it's bad for the fish. If you go and dump a whole load of dirty water into the river all at once, the fish really don't like it. It's really bad for them. It's a bit like going and taking a load of smoke and making it just, it's the equivalent of putting thick choking smoke into the air and then expecting to sit in it and breathe that for several hours, allowing it to dissipate. You're going to be annoyed by the person that is creating all that smoke. Fish are no doubt going to be annoyed by the person creating all of that muddy water, but we don't want to do it because of the fish. We don't want to upset the fish too much, but mostly the trouble arises because there are plenty of people who stick up for the fish. And they will come along and say, you shouldn't be doing that, and then they issue you with a fine. I don't want to have to pay a fine for putting dirty water into a river. I don't. Whilst I respect the fish, I also strongly respect my wallet, and I don't think I can afford the fine. it's lunchtime again. I filled in, well, it was over there, right where that sort of the side of the heap was. We filled all of that in where the water was, and that's piled it up. I've dug down really deep here, and then I've put in a load of the mud from the top. And now we're going to pile up stone on top of this, but we've got to go and have lunch first. And all of the water that was in that side is now slowly draining in into here. So we'll see what it's like in an hour after we've had some food and some coffee, and then we'll be back. I've had lunch. Let's have a look, see what the damage is. How much water has gone in there in an hour? We left the bucket flat on the surface. Okay, that's pretty good. It is amazing how much water is in this place. It is absolutely amazing. In winter, this is an absolute bog. You can't walk through it. You try walking across this little field here in the winter and you sink right up to your middle. And that is why there is a layer of, there's a 2 to 3 feet layer of peat bog right over the top of a mixture of clay and stone, and then it goes down and down to stone and lots of stone. Right. And start spooning it out. There we go, first bucket of water. I'm going to scoop a couple of buckets of water and put them in the field over here, like this. And we'll come back round over here again. I reckon we'll do three.
Thank you.
tried like seeing just how much we can do with this one in as far as like driving it on steep ground. I only left this alone for 5 minutes so that I could go and have a drink of coffee. Look at that. That's half a bucket deep, that water. I don't know if we can see it. Let me see if I can zoom in. You see the water running down the side? That's just running straight out of the ground. There is so much water here everywhere. Everything is covered in water. Everything is saturated. That's why we're doing this. Because you imagine this in the winter. Fly. Biting my leg. Yeah, you imagine this in the winter. We've hardly had any rain at all here for 2 months. And it's like this. You imagine in the winter when it's rained non-stop. For 2 months, or 3 months, or 4 months. Just rain, rain, rain. Then you imagine how wet it gets around here. That's why we're doing this. That's why we are putting all of this on the top. And we're gonna cover all of this with some lighter soil, but it's going to be slightly above the surrounding level, which will hopefully mean that we don't have a bog here in the winter.